Good afternoon, everyone, at First Platt Junior School. It's me, Mr. Kemp, here with your Monday afternoon assembly. And today's assembly is all about focusing on coming back to school, returning to school next Monday, the 8th of March. So I'm just going to share with you a little song that has some lyrics, which I will explain about after you hear this. So the lyrics from Taylor Swift, "We are never, ever, ever getting back together," kind of reminds me of people at home, pupils, students, teachers, staff that are at home that are never, ever, ever going to get back with their school life. Well, we've had the green light and it is a go from next Monday, the 8th. We're going to all be back together and we're all going to be returning to school ready for the rest of the term, to be working hard, staying safe as normal, and doing as best as we can to work hard and stay positive about everything going on in the world right now. So I just want to list some words and feelings about returning to school next week. You might be excited, happy, positive, nervous, worried, cautious, frightened, scared. All of these different words, every single one of us is feeling something about next Monday on returning to school. And it's okay to feel a little unsure and a bit anxious when coming back next week, but you have to remember, everything we do at First Platt in our big school is to help protect the people and the students and the staff, and of course, to keep everyone safe. So as you know, when you return next Monday, we will have still our one-way system coming up the drive through the big gates, seeing myself or Mrs. Clark or Mrs. B, whoever's on this morning gate duty, to welcome you with a big hello and a happy smile on returning next Monday. And then when you go into school, you'll obviously be attending your classroom and you'll have your classroom bubbles. And you just got to make sure the first thing when we get in is washing hands at the sink in our classrooms before doing anything else. That is very important. And it's the same of what we did back before Christmas, before obviously this lockdown. So washing hands, another key thing. Obviously at break time and lunchtime, we're still gonna be playing outside because outside is best for everything going on right now. But obviously you'll still be in your bubbles and year group bubbles and you'll all have your playing zones like before. So remembering where you can go, where you can't go is also very, very important. And lastly, it's the most obvious one for me, but it's maintaining a safe distance from other bubbles, other year groups. You shouldn't be mixing with anybody else, as you already know. So we have been through this from September through to Christmas, had a little break, had another lockdown at home. But now it's just a reminder to you guys, these small things that we're putting in for you as a school to keep you safe, to keep everyone distance when we return on Monday the 8th, which is next week. I know I am super excited. I really want to see everybody. I want to teach outside in an open space rather than from my front room, as many of you have joined me in the last few weeks, which has been a great success. But I can't wait to just get outside, do some sports, play some games, and just enjoy every minute that I have with each year group and each class. And we also have to remember, most importantly, how we feel of course, is important, but how other people also feel when returning next week. So make sure we are supportive of one another and supportive of your staff members as well, behaving like we should be in and around school, which is the first Platt way anyway. And that's just a few things to remember next week. Now, what I want to do for you now, I want to show you a coronavirus video that was made on returning to school back in the summer. And I watched this video and I thought, so we're going to go back next week. And it's very, very relatable to what happened in September when we returned after the summer. So I'd like to share the video with you to give you and remind you of the things we expect in school. So let me just load this video and then we can get started. Here we go. Okay. Are we ready? So this is all about returning to school and back to school after our lockdown. I just hope it plays.
It'll soon be time to get back to school. As much as you might be looking forward to it, you might also be wondering what exactly it'll be like. Well, it's true, things will be a bit different because your school's making some important changes to keep everyone safe. One thing you might be wondering is what exactly you can bring to school. Well, you should only bring what you absolutely need. This might include bags, lunchboxes, coats, books, pens, pencils, and maybe mobile phones, but check with your school first. Your day will start with the journey to school. It's best to walk, cycle, or scoot your way there if you can. If you do need to use public transport, such as a bus, train, or tram, try to maintain social distancing. Grown-ups and children who are 11 and over should wear face coverings unless they have a reason not to. When you arrive, you'll notice some of the changes your school has made to keep you safe. And one of these might be bubbles. Sounds fun, but bubbles are really just groups of pupils, and your school will be trying to keep your group away from other groups. You'll still get to see your friends, but for safety, your school may want different bubbles to arrive at different times. They'll let you know if they do. On your way to your classroom, you might notice signs telling you how to stay safe. And when you get there, the desks may all be facing forward. These changes are important for everyone's safety. It'll be great to see your teacher again, and they'll be happy to give you just as much help as usual. Now, look around. Everything's been given a good clean, and you can help stay safe by remembering to wash your hands for 20 seconds with soap and water too. Your school probably won't be having assemblies at first. You'll still get to play sports though. These will be games you can play outside without getting too close to each other. And look at that, it's home time. Remember, it's best to walk, cycle or scoot if you can, and try to keep your distance if you're taking a bus, train or tram. And if you do take public transport, grown-ups and children who are 11 and over should wear face coverings unless they have a reason not to. And you're home. See, you'll still be able to learn, play games and see your friends. We all just need to be aware of the changes, follow the guidelines and enjoy getting back to school.
So there we have it. I will come off the screen share now as we finish that video. So you could see that, I'll keep talking, from the video, as I've previously mentioned about washing hands, one-way systems, if you're coming to school, try and use a bike, a scooter, walk to school, all these different things will keep us more protective and more safe. And also, I just want to mention, I've got something that you can take from me. I've created this and it's called the ABC, which is A is for actions we can do, like washing hands, keeping our distance, covering our nose and mouths when coughing or sneezing. B is for us to behave. Let's be clean to be safe, using appropriate behaviour throughout our school day, which I'm sure we will all do anyway. And C is for classroom. Go straight in, keep in your groups, and stay within your bubble. So if you remember the ABC, which is actions, behave, and classroom, you will have no problems in returning to school next Monday, the 8th of March, which will be very, very different for every single one of you for different reasons. But just remember also, you know, being a primary school, you don't have to wear face coverings. However, some staff and teachers will be wearing face masks like they were before Christmas. And it's just a sign for protecting you as children, protecting us as adults. We are still the same First Platt school as before. We want to stay positive, which we always are. And as I said, I'm really, really looking forward to seeing as many of you on Monday morning, giving you lots of smiles and good mornings on the gate. So I'm excited. I hope you have a little bit of excitement too in seeing everybody else. And you get to be back with your friends, back with your classmates, back in your classroom, which is really, really important. And I'd also just advise, there have been children in school over the last few weeks who their parents or guardians are key workers, and they already have a little bit of experience of going back to school. So maybe as groups and individuals, you can help everyone else returning next Monday and making them feel welcome and making everyone at First Platt be positive, happy, and bringing it to its joyful place that it always is and always will be. That's it from me on today's Monday Assembly. I hope you are excited, just like me, returning next Monday. I can't wait to see you, and I hope you have a fantastic week. Take care, stay safe, keep active, and I'll see you very, very soon. Bye-bye.